Hello, welcome back to the Fish Locker, out on the rocks. We're out on the rock mark and we're spinning for pollock. Now Tom got down here literally three casts before me. I haven't even set up yet. And he's into his second pollock. First one was about £3. And he's just trying to find a way of landing this one. I'll take it down and I'll show you it just in case he misses it.
I'll just take it in that shallow behind.
You've got to try and catch it on an in wave so the water lands the fish for you. A cracking pollock. Now what do you say, £5?
Four and a half, five. Not cheating anymore.
Brilliant. Like I say, He's literally been down here three casts. That's what he's had. I haven't even had a chance to set up yet. Things are looking good. A big one compared to that one that Tom's just had, but cracking fishing. You can see it's absolutely smothered, it's mullered that lure. There you go, that's what it was. It was a sidewinder, Skerry's real eel. See, all we're doing is Tom's fishing a metal lure and I'm fishing a soft plastic. Tom's is managing to sink faster than mine. I'm going to have to leave plenty of slack line to let it sink and then engage the bail arm.
Sorry.
We're having to fish with a very tight drag and all the rocks in front of us, it's real deep here. There's kelp all along where we are, so if you don't manage to get them up out there, they dive into the kelp. Tom's just lost one there and I nearly lost the last one. All I'm fishing is I'm fishing the Nomura Iso, I call it a spinning rod, but it's a light boat setup. It's a 12 to 20 pound class rod, Nabu Cardinal and a 30 pound braid. I think I've got a 20 pound fluoro leader. What are you fishing with, Tom?
It's just a light 35 gram cheap Abu rod. I normally like 10 feet of rod for here, gives you a bit more off the edge, but unfortunately I stood on it in the garage, so that was the end of that.
Yeah, there's another one. Saw there all I was doing. That. You see the lure in its mouth? You see what I got it on there? That's one of the Skerry's real eels. Come up here and we'll have a double shot of them. Bring it up here, come on. Now look at that, two fish, two casts. Been a fantastic stamp so far, they're around about 4 or 5 pounds.
Lovely quality fish.
Oh, fantastic, been perfect. This one's got a couple of lice on it. Ah, they're cracking, aren't they? It's almost a fish a chuck here so far. Certain fish, like big bass, when you properly play them out, when you get them to the side of the boat, on the side of the shore, and you can tell that they're knackered and they're really lethargic, they need recovery. They need holding in the water and recovery. But a fish like this, when they come in and they're still real rigid and they've still got plenty of fight in them, if you can kind of torpedo them in head first, it gives them a kick start. Not only does it get a burst of fresh oxygenated water over its gills, it spurs them on to swimming. So if you can torpedo them in head first, they'll be away. So you might have seen me there, we've just been kind of tossing these back. We haven't been tossing them so they land flat. If you kind of torpedo them so they go in head first, they go back better. Now I've had, I don't know what, I've had two fish off this, three fish. I'm going to switch it to something else and see what I can catch on. So we'll see if we can catch it on some other coloured lures now. Alright, this is the Skerry's Real Eel. Oh, is it super real? Smashed it. Look, it's dead strong. Got a great hookup. Try something else. The reason why I'm going to try probably a bloodhead or maybe even a rattleback now, just because they're slightly heavier and I want them to sink faster. Try one of these. There you go, look. That was literally the first cast with that bloodhead. All I managed to do was I just let it sink. Just let the lure sink almost to the bottom and then just engage the bail arm, just gently tugged it like that, flicked it, and then on a third bounce, bam. Fantastic fish. You can see these are living in kelp because they're still mottled down here. Because they're so hard fighting, because they're fishing right amongst the kelp and the rocks, the drag is very, very tight. It's tight. Yeah. The pollock will do a crashing dive. As soon as they hook up, they will go. You need to stop them from getting into that kelp. Literally, all I'm doing is I'm feathering the line out. I'm watching the line out there. You'll see it running away as it sinks, and as soon as it starts to slow down or stop, it means you've either hooked the fish up on the way down or it's hooked up. Look, all for camera, you saw that exactly what I did. There's the fish. Not a big one, but still absolutely perfect. See the lure there in its mouth, look. There he is. That's a Skerry's bloodhead. The reason I'm using this is because it's slightly harder. Sorry, it's not a Skerry's bloodhead, it's a Sidewinder bloodhead. The reason I'm using this rather than the Skerry's is because this is slightly heavier. This towel is perfect for this. Thanks, Matty. When you're handling fish like that and you're having a cast, you're having a wind, you don't want the rod to get all plaited up. Perfect to have a little towel like this. What I'm doing here, oh, there's a knock. as I was saying, what I was doing there was, I know the tide's running round like that, so I just held the lure in the tide and let the line stay tight. Again there, you saw exactly what I did. I was just talking to you as I was doing it. It's taking a little bit of damage, but it's still working. As I was busy saying to you there, it's definitely paying off letting the lure sink. This mark where we're at is quite deep. And all I'm doing is I'm paying line out like that, watching the line leave as it keeps tightening and disappearing under the water. I know it's sinking. As soon as it stops, engage the bail arm, give it one wind, and then just holding the rod tip. The tide's running that way, so it's going to carry the lure in your line that way, so it's keeping the line tight. And the lure will be swimming in the tide, just round like a big arm. And as soon as you feel a bump, I just lower the rod tip a little bit and then take it.
Nice little male cuckoo.
Been fishing close to the bottom and found him. Let it have some slack and then bring it back in towards me. Without exaggeration, this is probably the 8th fish we've had of this size in probably 12 casts. I know this bloodhead works well. Right, so we know that this absolutely nails them with the extra weight. I was just having to let the Skerry's eel sink for longer, the real eel. It was still catching them, but it was just taking longer to get to the bottom. So what I'm going to try from the little bag of tricks, I'm going to try one of these Crusader shads. Just because they're smaller, so they should sink. They're smaller yet still the same weight, so they should sink well. And I'm also going to try. These are what I use on the wrecks from the boat. It's called the rattleback. They're heavier in the head and they've got a little rattle in the tail. I think these will absolutely slay it. Also, with it being a deep rock mark, there is a chance of a ling in this area. So we've got a little side bet going as to who's the first one that's going to get a ling. These are rattlebacks. We've got a little tiny rattle in it there, look. Comes into another fish there in the background.
The lovely fish of a similar stamp. It's going to get the red down, isn't it?
That was literally the first cast with that rattleback. Nailed it. Right. I hooked a good fish. Piped me off on the rocks down there, so I just changed my leader. I lost that rattleback. So what I did was I swapped it over. It's one of the Crusader shads that I was talking about earlier. Well, it's still young. Swipped it over to one of these. Because I said I thought these would be quite good because they've got a heavy head and a small body, so they would sink quite quickly. They would just sink like that. Literally, first drop. Now, this isn't a big one. It's down, it's back somewhere to attack that. If it was a coarse fish, I would have said that would have been a cormorant. Usually, an attack on the back of a fish like that is from a cormorant. Every single one of them has been prime fighting. Cracking spot. Yeah, that one was on there. One of these Crusader shads. You might be able to see there. It's all up to good fish out there, and as soon as you got it down here, it's managed to get itself into the pub. You've got two options there. You can either try and change the angle on it to try and get it out, or you've tried letting some slack up to let the fish come out by itself, because it's not going to swim further into the rock, it's going to go out. The only problem is because there's that much kelp around, as soon as they get down there and they get the line wrapped around some of it. If you use strong braid, I mean I've got 30 pound braid on here, so hopefully it'll be able to pull the kelp out. That's the nature of the beast.
See there where the fish is buried into the weed, bit of the lighter weed, but there's a lot of kelp down there. Like John was mentioning, leave it go slack, the fish will hopefully swim out. Or if you change the angle, you get round the kelp.
Just fight like a steam train. See where it smashed that little Crusader shad there. That was it. That literally took 15 yards off, but real deep. So just to kind of guide it along. cracking fish.
For the nice fish, green sidewinder.
Literally the first cast for it as well. Yeah, it was brilliant. But you said, oh, I'll just try a soft plastic, so we haven't tried one of these yet. First cast with it, nil. I had a fantastic session on the bass recently with these sidewinder lures, so I thought, right, I'll give them a crack and I'll see what they've got. And I just bought a pack of everything, so I'm going to try everything. So far, they've all been fantastic.
In the rolling light, they're all different.
They all seem to have their uses. Like they all seem to be good at a certain type. These deeper rock marks, the heavier ones seem to be fishing better. The area where we're fishing, Tom found it a while ago, didn't he? And all they were doing was they were looking on charts for areas that were deep and really rocky close into the shore. That's all you want to find. It needs to be deep and ideally rocky and kelpy, because they're living amongst the rocks and the kelp and like hide out of the way of the tide, and whenever a decent tide run coming past, any bait fish or anything that comes past, they come out and try and get it. Like an ambush predator. We've just had some in, there's a patch of kelp down underneath us and it's maybe only 6 foot below the surface. I was just winding in. It's just come out, man. Yeah, look, that's a double shot.
Symmetrical.
Man's bigger. What do you mean symmetrical?
Ah, mine's bigger.
Look at that. Right on camera. Got a fantastic, fantastic mouth for swallowing fish, look. That great big eye shows it's a predator. And like loads of fins, a great big paddle tail. That's how it goes such a turn of speed.
It's flat.
Straight down. If you can get them in head first like that, just doosh, and they just power away. Yes, I was using the blood heads. And Tom's using a green one. I'm not sure what the green one is.
What are those green ones called?
Yeah. So far, I think these bloodheads have been showing best. But that's just because it's a nice bright colour and it's a bit of an overcast day. But the deeper fish have been the bigger fish. The shallower fish have been the smaller fish. So a heavier lure has been working better for us. We've just had a couple of pollock follow it right in the white water behind us, right up high on the surface. So I'm going to try one of these poppers. Now, I don't usually surface fish, but a couple of guys that have commented on the videos have said, if you haven't caught it off the surface, it doesn't count. And I thought, right, well, challenge accepted. We'll have a crack and we'll see if we can get one on the surface. The fishing here on this mark started to really slow down. We've been getting... This, I've just had this cracking fish here on one of the bloodheads again. But they've slowed right down and they're getting quite small, some of them. So what happens sometimes is you can fish a mark out, fish it really well, and then it'll slow right down and it'll drop off, and it just means that you've caught all the fish that are there and they've moved on. So all we're going to do is I'm going to hook this, get her back, I'm going to move further down the coast and try and back down there. You see that lure in there?
Camera on. danger mark. Another lovely stamp of fish. Nice and ginger.
Like the deer.
Like the deer.
Birds are working out there with that.
I've used this lure. I think it's reached the end of its life. Tail's torn up, head's poking out, but it's landed probably around 50 pounds of fish. I've had at least 10 to 12 pollock on this one fish, on this one lure. So I think he's earned a retirement. I'm going to try one of the heavier ones, because Tom's getting them on the metals, I aren't getting them on the plastics, so he's letting it sink. We'll try that. Time's coming that we're going to have to go. We've had some fantastic pollock fishing. All of it just close inshore with soft plastics or metals. Now we've caught pretty much on everything. He says, I'm just getting a knock there. We've caught pretty much on everything. Tom's done well on the metals. He's been fishing them down near the bottom, and I've been doing well on the soft plastics. The best ones were the bigger, heavier ones, like the sand eels or the bloodheads. There's a massive grey seal just popped up. I don't know if I can show you.
Oh, no.
See it there? So yeah, I think it's about time that we're packing up now.
Get my lure out of the way.
Where's the tax, man?
These have done really well for me. I hooked the best fish of the day so far, saw it up on the surface and crash dived and lost it on one of these. They have got a heavier head and they have got a little rattle in the tail. The best fish that we managed to land were probably around about. There's that seal there, look. See him down there. With a pollock in his mouth.
There's my fish.
Yeah. Greedy sod. Taxman's here to collect his two pennies. So we've had a fantastic day, just fishing light. I was fishing, the rods weren't really long enough. If you had a 10 foot rod, this is only a 7 foot. If you had a 10 foot rod, you'd be able to guide it out round the rocks and round the kelp better. But this has done okay. I was fishing 30 pound braid, 20 pound fluoro, and I had these sidewinder lures. The bloodheads and the big sand eels did really well because they were a little bit heavier. The lighter ones, like the real eels and the skerries, we tried those too, but we're having to let them sink for longer, so we weren't getting as many fish. I hope the video's turned out alright. I hope you've seen the fish. I hope you enjoy it, and take it easy. Have a good one.